Hello, everyone. Google has released a major update to Stitch, its AI-powered tool for UI design and front-end code generation. Stitch lets you create complete interface designs and production-ready code using simple text prompts, sketches, or screenshots, and it's currently available for free. You describe what you want, and Stitch generates responsive layouts that can be exported directly to Figma, sent to Google's AI Builder, or downloaded locally as code. In this video, I'll break down what's new in this update and how it impacts real-world development workflows. First, choose whether you're building a mobile app or a web UI. As you can see, Stitch now includes two new options. The first two options were covered in the earlier video. With Fast Mode, you can export designs directly to Figma. Thinking with Gemini 3.0 Pro, which focuses on reasoning and quality, and Redesign, powered by Nano Banana Pro. Select Gemini 3.0 Pro, enter your prompt, and submit it. Generation starts immediately, and you can switch between modes within the same project, something that wasn't possible before. Here, you can see the SaaS landing page we generated, and the quality comes from using Gemini 3 Pro. You can also view the generated code. By default, Stitch outputs HTML with Tailwind CSS, and you can download the full source folder, including the UI screenshot and HTML files. This is the generated HTML running in the browser, which highlights how well Gemini 3 performs for front-end code inside Stitch. Stitch now includes a new variation generation panel. You can start by choosing how many design options you want to generate. Next, set the creative range, refine, medium, or YOLO, which controls how conservative or experimental the output is. You can also add custom instructions, like enforcing a specific style or layout direction. Below that, you can decide which aspects to vary, such as layout, color scheme, images, fonts, or text content. Once everything is set, clicking Generate Variations produces multiple design alternatives within the same project. Once the design is ready, you can export it in multiple ways. You can send it everything directly to Google AI Studio, export the files as a zip, copy the code to your clipboard, or hand it off to Jules. When you choose AI Studio, Stitch opens it automatically and downloads the HTML and image assets in the background. This makes it easy to move from design to actual implementation without any manual setup. Another export option here is Jules. Jules is Google's autonomous coding assistant that takes these generated screens and helps turn them into a working project. You can connect it to a repository, add a short description of what you want to build, and let Jules handle the implementation steps. This is useful if you want to move beyond static UI and start wiring things into a real code base. When you choose Build with AI Studio, you can add an additional description and continue from there. Stitch automatically passes the source context, including the HTML and UI screenshots, and redirects everything into AI Studio. From there, you can extend the project further. AI Studio converts the HTML into a structured React plus TypeScript codebase instead of a single flat HTML file. This results in a more professional folder structure, and in some cases, it even enhances the UI. For example, automatically adding a yearly pricing option. Once the landing page is ready, you can continue building out the rest of the application from that foundation. With the new prototypes feature, you can stitch multiple screens together into an interactive flow. You can click through screens, test transitions, and validate the overall user journey before moving to development. This makes it easier to catch UX issues early, without exporting anything. If you notice any UI issues, you can keep editing directly in Stitch. Just describe what you want to change and submit it, and the tool updates the design automatically. For example, a responsiveness issue with a button was fixed immediately. By uploading images or entering a website URL, you can use existing designs as a reference and regenerate the UI inside Stitch. As you can see, the generated layout closely matches the reference website. Using the Nano Banana-powered Annotate feature, you can mark areas of the design to add, remove, or adjust specific layout elements. This update also adds a command palette aimed at power users. Instead of navigating through menus, you can press Command or Control K and trigger actions directly by typing. This makes it much faster to jump between screens, run commands, and adjust the canvas without breaking your flow. If you're working on large or multi-screen projects, this significantly speeds things up. Stitch now introduces predictive heat maps. You can instantly run an attention audit on any screen to see where users are most likely to focus. This helps you validate visual hierarchy before writing any code, without waiting for real user data. The feature is available now in the Generate menu. With Gemini 3.0 Pro now powering Stitch by default, the platform removes many of the previous limits on what can be generated. Designs are now reasoned through before any code is written, resulting in stronger layouts, cleaner structure, and more reliable front-end output. This is especially noticeable in complex interfaces like dashboards and multi-screen flows, where visual reasoning and DOM structure really matter. And because every design is backed by real, exportable code, Stitch is no longer just a design tool. It's a practical starting point for building real applications. Thanks for watching. I'll check out the next one.